Good afternoon. Thank you so much for coming to the second annual Canvas at Yale Lightning Talks. I'm very excited to have a bunch of great presenters today. I just want to thank everyone who helped out with the setup today, who helped getting everybody ready. And this was a labor of love. And thank you so much to everyone who helped make this happen here today. I want to jump right in and get started on everything. So the first thing, here we have Yulia, who is going to be our first presenter. And Yulia is a senior lector in the Slavic department and is a Canvas quiz guru. Aside from teaching, Yulia has published articles in a lot of national peer-reviewed journals and is also interested in working with technology, digital humanities, and heritage language learning. And today she's going to be talking about how she integrated the Canvas quizzes into her course.
Thank you so much. Thank you all for coming. It's great to see so many familiar faces, and some of you teach language too, so I hope that you would find this presentation helpful, because as I was telling Timberly, language teachers invariably do a lot of grading. And I will tell you a little bit about the structure of this course and why I find Canvas so helpful. So I teach and oversee introductory Russian, first year Russian. As many introductory language courses at Yale, it has multiple sections. So I'm the course coordinator. I oversee multiple sections, and I get every year new teaching assistants who have never taught before. So obviously, one of the paramount tasks is to ensure that grading is consistent across multiple sections. And as anybody who has been in the similar situation knows, it is very difficult for an experienced teacher to teach a new teacher to grade exactly like yourself, because it's not just finding the correct answer that you can teach them to do. You will give the key. That's not a problem. But to make sure how certain components of the test are evaluated as a whole. Is it worth 1 point? Is it worth half a point? Is it considered a spelling error? Is it considered a repeated error, in which case you would not, and so forth. And again, the other challenge that we have in introductory language classes, we want to give these quizzes and exams fairly often. We cannot teach a class where we just give a midterm and the final. That would have disastrous results. I know that majority of my colleagues, and as do we in Russian, we have biweekly unit tests. That means they're graded. Students get a letter, or in Canvas case, it's percentage grade. And we, on the weeks that are off weeks from the test, we have what we call low-stakes quizzes. That is to say, this would also be a quiz, but it'll be shorter. And instead of a letter grade, you will have a percentage. Why do we do that? We feel that in introductory level, it's very important to have this, what we call level checks or progress measurements. Because if student gets a very low score on this interim low-stake quiz, then it tells them, okay, well, the material on this unit really needs more work. So by the time they approach unit test, they already had that feedback. And again, I know that this is something that, again, I see Shiri in Hebrew and Angela in Korean. We all have this approach. It's very important to give the student frequent feedback. At the same time, so in paper testing, it also, in addition to obvious challenges for uniformity of grading, as I said, there was another challenge of simply if you correct mistake by hand, the student may or may not be able to decipher what you wrote. It's a huge problem in the larger assignment, say, because each test invariably has a free writing portion, and I'll show you in a minute, you know, whether they are able to read your corrections, God only knows. Whether they read it, you don't know either. So in Canvas, it's taken care of beautifully because you can type your feedback and student will immediately see it. You will also set up the test, and I will show you, where the correct answers are immediately shown. And we've used this feature, typically we use this feature because at Yale, fortunately, we don't have a problem with academic dishonesty. So once you hit submit, you will immediately see, just like you do now on SATs or GRE, you will have your raw score. So by raw score, I mean, of course, then I will invariably go into the exam and make sure that machine has subtracted the points correctly. And there is also a free writing portion of each test, which the Canvas now currently cannot grade, but I will grade by hand and I will leave comments. So again, for us, using Canvas in first year Russian has proven to be of tremendous benefit, both on the learner's progress, because then it assures transparency. Students see exactly what went wrong. On consistency of grading, then there are no more debates. Oh, you've taken for this, you didn't take for that, and so forth, across the sections. And of course, the frequent feedback. Finally, there is a great organizational benefit, because we've all been in a situation when a student is sick or they have to go out of town. In other words, they have a legitimate excuse that they cannot take the test with a group, and then you have to somehow make arrangements so that they have to come in during the office hours. And again, even on organizational level, it's very difficult because you have to find mutually convenient time to proctor. Again, Canvas takes care of it wonderfully, because you as a teacher, if you know that the reason is legitimate, you can open the test on demand, which sometimes we do. And it works beautifully. What else we do? Presume your student did very poorly on the exam, and it's up to the teacher to decide whether how you want to approach it. Presume somebody, I don't know, got very stressed, or they had some sort of issue, and they got very low raw score. Then you can go into the test and allow second attempt, and it will be measured. So now I will demonstrate for you. I put on the abstract that I will show you my fall semester, but that doesn't really matter because I'm working with this now. So this is my second semester of this. Again, I've used it last year too, so it's a second year or the fourth semester of this. So how that works? So quizzes. So the children are not confused. So each chapter is organized into these modules. So you can see in January, we started with Unit 7. There is a vocabulary quiz, because they said when they're due, right? And then there is a chapter test, which is invariably last. So what do I do with a unit test? Low-stake quizzes. All quizzes are worth only 10% of total grades. So again, it's that low-stake testing, which research has shown has tremendous benefits, because you want to test without like students being too stressed about it. So I will preview so you see what the test looks like. I don't know if I can go and show in the privacy interest the quiz statistics. So it looks like this. Okay, you can set it up. It's just a simple vocabulary quiz. Everybody does it. It's very standard. So from English into Russian, then you have some components which will go. On this one, it's only from English into Russian. But usually, typically, I set up two ways. If it's vocabulary quiz, it will be from into the target language, and then from target language back into English. You can, of course, change it at any time. So what is super super nice about this, if you want to see how people did in a particular section or across the board, if your quiz was set up well, you go into this and it will show you overall performance. So you see, people did pretty good. I don't know if it shows me the average score, 90%, very nice. So obviously it was set up well. I'll show you one more thing because I get the card for questions. I'll show you the test, okay? You want to see the test a little bit, just one, because I do say it's once to see. Same thing. So test just one. So grading is beautiful. So listening, of course. Nobody has any problems with listening. So green, you don't worry about the green, okay? So red, of course, you have to see how the Canvas how Canvas scores it. Mm? So here, there was nothing for me to do because obviously, I went in and there was issues. There were various issues here. It's not the best test to show, of course. But in any case, you only look. So the green one, you don't even have to worry. It's a tremendous time saver because green, you just scroll. Red one, you should see. Like here, you see, I awarded her 2.5 points because I gave her back half the credit for here because I treated it as a spelling error. So on the red one, you look, and then you go. Again, this is a very poor example to show because obviously it's a very bad work. But this is a free writing. And then, so look. So this is a free writing for the free writing prompt, right? So students write. Then I can, when I give her, I say, look, this is only worth 14 out of possible 20 points. Then I tell her here why it is, because I have this comment, you see, where I correct her issues. Here, for overall comment, I didn't say anything, but it allows you to put the comments in, like, see, this work was turned in late. You see that? So it's very nice. If you have multiple attempts, it will show you, well, this is obviously a very good work, 99.5. and so forth. But it's wonderful because then, again, they can see immediately the problems, what they need to work on and improve. And again, I can go back to quiz statistics and I will see how the sections did it. Yeah? Questions? Yeah? Yes.
Are these in-class tests and quizzes, or are these take-home?
Excellent question. So unit test, the one that you're looking at now, will be taken in class because there is also a listening component that I will play. They don't have listening before. Listening will be played in class. So anything where they get letter grade, and these are weighted heavier because unit tests count for 40% of the grade, of overall grade. So yes, I will do that in class. Vocabulary quizzes, which was the first item demonstrated. Vocabulary quizzes are considered low stake item, and those would be done out of class time. But that's a good point because what I intend to do later, maybe next academic year, I want to add more of these low-stake quizzes. So rather than giving like one a week, maybe I'll give a couple a week because it's always good. How else you can teach, you can make them learn vocabulary? You know, you've seen that problem.
Who set up your Canvas presence? Did you do it yourself, or did you hire an expert?
Well, I had great help from Christine Constantina, and so we worked together. She was generous, very generous with her time. And again, both Timberly and Christine have really helped tremendously. And now, every time I have a problem, because I still do, I ask Christine, and she helps me. But I mean, again, the more you use it, the better it gets. The first time I thought it was horrible because, you know, every answer is a new screen. You realize that. But, I mean, eventually you get a hang of it. And again, I mean, truth be told, it is time-consuming to set up, but it's absolutely well worth it because, like, last year we spent tremendous amount of time setting it up, but now it's all there. So now I can concentrate on modifying and adding because also, I'm sure somebody will talk about it, Canvas has this beautiful button, Copy Resources, of which I can happily talk next time because resources, too, are much easier to maintain and copy from semester to semester. It's really, I mean, I'm a huge fan of this program. Absolutely.
Can you shuffle the order of the questions? Can you shuffle words or order or?
You can. I mean, for my particular situation, it's not practical. But yes, absolutely. When you say set up the quiz, you can absolutely do. You can have bank of questions, and it will pick from the bank. Again, for us, because the first year or introductory languages are so sequential, I can do it in my other class, for example, like in advanced or whatever, in heritage. But in the introductory language level, the points that you wish to test are so few and so particular that you don't want to. So the answer is yes, the system allows that, but we don't do it for this particular course.
Great. Thank you so much.